The two faces of Max. On one hand, the People's Party leader, Max Bernier, is fighting to build pipelines. He wants to get rid of supply management. He wants to change the equalization formula. He's trying to put his new party on the map. On the other side, he's beating the Twitter drum about global government that will, in his words, destroy Canada. So as he gets ready to put candidates in his first by-elections next month, just what kind of party is Max Bernier leading? Let's find out. Max Bernier joins us right now. Mr. Bernier, always good to have you on the program. I know you've got ideas on pipelines and immigration, and we'll get to that. But I got to ask you first, and I'm following you on
yes.
Twitter. Why have you embraced and supported this idea that Canada could be destroyed, your term, by what you call global government?
What I said was very clear and based on facts. In 2010, Justin Trudeau, member of parliament, promote a campaign by the UN, the UNPA website, to create a world parliament that will have legislation and laws that are binding for countries. So the question is very legitimate to ask Justin Trudeau if he still believes that we must have a world parliament, like maybe the European Parliament, that will make laws that will apply to Canada. So
okay,
I think that's a legitimate question.
Okay, but that's not, if you want to ask a legitimate question, but here's my concern. You tweeted in capital
yes.
letters, is he, Justin Trudeau, yes. loyal to Canada or loyal to a future world government that will destroy Canada? You know, this kind of world government is often associated, in your own words, with paranoid, conspiracy-minded, anti-globalist, that this is a, I understand he actually signed this, I've gone to the website and I've read it, but you and I both know the chances of this happening are next to nothing. Why are you using this to get attention? Is it a sign of desperation?
No, absolutely not. Because the question it is not if that parliament will happen in 10 years or 20 years from now. The question is, we have a prime minister in office right now that believes in a world parliament, and he is making decision with that belief.
But Maxime Bernier, why are you aligning? You know the fellow travelers with this kind of stuff. You know the people that peddle this kind of stuff. It's marginalized stuff. We've got real issues happening now. I've known you for a long time. Doesn't this make you look like a desperate person reaching for extreme views so you can get some attention? Doesn't it undermine your credibility?
Absolutely not. You know, I'm speaking about real stuff, like you said, real policies, and I'm the only politician to speak about that. And it's a legitimate question to ask, and I want to know if he's still believing that. So that's it.
Okay. Let me talk about some issues, because you're trying to put your party
yes.
on the map. China. When you ran for the leadership of the Conservative Party, you really wanted free trade with China. Meantime, China is now threatening Canada. They've used words like white supremacy. Do you still advocate free trade with China?
No, I don't. You know, I changed my idea about that with everything that is happening recently. I think it is not important to have a free trade agreement with China. It is not a priority, and I'm not for that right now. And I don't see a future free trade with China. I think the most important is to work with our allies and developing a very good relationship with the U.S. and our allies. And you know what China they're doing right now, they're a dictatorship, and we know that. So the most
important
is
What does Trudeau need to do? Does he kick out the Chinese ambassador now? What does he do right now?
But I must admit that up to now, I think the Trudeau government did the right thing on that subject. And, you know, we must try to have diplomatic relationship. But when the ambassador is insulting us, I think we must respond to that. You know, it's not true that we are white supremacists in Canada. It's very crazy to say that. And so I think we must be we must tell the truth to the Chinese diplomats in Ottawa.
You've got three by-elections coming up, and people are still trying to figure out what kind of party you are. In Burnaby South, where you have a candidate running against Jagmeet Singh, the NDP leader, your candidate is a woman named Laura Lynn Tyler-Thompson. She's been openly teaching about sexual orientation and gender identity in schools, saying that the teaching about that is bad. She thinks it's gender fluid ideology. Let me ask you a couple questions. Do you support a campaign about teaching against sexual orientation?
First of all, you must have the facts right. She did a campaign and she was against that the state, the provincial parliament, teach to young children that maybe they're not a boy if they're a boy, and if they're a girl, maybe they're not a girl. She's against that. That's what she said, and that's what she believes. And she has the right of her belief. And I said that publicly, and I'm very, very proud of her as a candidate. It's a provincial matters, and me as a federal politician,
What's your view in the party? I'm just trying to figure out. Do you believe she thinks being transgender? She says it's called gender fluid ideology. I'm using her words. Would you use that word?
Yeah. For me, she has her own point of view, and you know I respect that.
But it's your party. It's not Maxime Bernier. It's your party. She's representing you.
Yeah. But. The most important is she agrees with our party, with our platform, with our bold reform that we want to do more freedom, less government, lower taxes, a balanced budget, fewer immigrants. She agrees with that and she will fight for that if she elected.
Okay, so let me just ask you, if you agree with those, if that's your party platform and you have different views on transgender or same-sex people, couples, and the views that is anything goes on the social conservative agenda for you?
Like I said, you know, it's not part of our agenda. Gay marriage, these social issues are not part of the agenda of our party. But she has the right to have strong views on that. You know, we're in a free country. We have pro-life people in this country and pro-choice people in this country. And in our party, we'll have pro-life people and pro-choice people, and that's okay. But the most important, every candidate will fight for our platform to be a reality.
Okay, last question, because obviously there's going to be lots more time to talk about this. Just straight up question. Do you believe in human-caused climate change? Do you believe climate change is an issue? And do you believe that humans cause climate change? Do you?
Okay, what I said, first of all, I know that there is climate change. Climate change exists, first. Second, I know that the CO2, it's part of the gases that create the greenhouse gases and that create the climate change. So I believe in that. What I said, and I will repeat that, CO2, it's a gas that is essential for life and like water. But too much CO2 with other gases create the green gas effects, okay, and I understand that.
I think I'm very clear about that. But
what I said, I just want to finish about it. What I said also, at the federal level, we won't impose a carbon tax and we won't do anything on climate change. It's a shared jurisdiction with provinces. Oh. And like right now, some provinces want to do something, like my own province in Quebec, they have a cap and trade system to fight climate change, and other provinces, they don't want to do anything about that.
Okay, but so your party would do nothing on it, that's the answer.
My party will do nothing on climate change because environment, it's a shared jurisdiction, and provinces, they have program for that, and so I'll let provinces decide what they're going to do to fight climate change. Yes, you're right.
Okay. Lots more to come. I know these conversations will continue. You're facing your first by-elections with three candidates coming up in February. Max Bernier, thank you so much, sir. Appreciate it.
Thank you.